Hey guys, so I got these two Anon Star microscopes and both come with these two flimsy LEDs. Since I don't use the original stands, I use a microphone boom arm instead, which allows for a lot more freedom of movement, I decided to build an LED ring light. I started by removing the lenses, which are identical on both models. I then put them on top of an LED aluminum substrate PCB. And although it is a tight fit, I realized that if I soldered the LEDs all the way to the edge, I could fit the lens in the middle. The idea is to hold the LED ring to the microscope by sandwiching it in between the lens and the lens assembly. And this way, since the lens assembly is made of quite thick aluminum, it would act as a heatsink. I then grabbed my step drill and enlarged the hole. If you do this, I recommend using a hole saw instead if you have one, and secure the PCB to a vise. Next, I checked if everything would work as planned, and it seemed possible. Great! Next, I cleaned the PCB and tinned all the pads, and here starts the tricky part. To improve the thermal dissipation, I applied solder to the middle pads of the LEDs, but this made the soldering job a lot harder. If I do this again, I would use bismuth low melting point solder paste instead and would heat the PCB from the bottom either with my hot air station or with my preheating plate. You could also use thermal glue on the bottom of the LEDs and solder the leads with the soldering iron. If you use hot air, make sure to never heat the LEDs directly from the top, as these melt very easily. I'm using 3-watt neutral white LEDs, but I found that 1-watt LEDs will be sufficient, as I'm not driving them even near 3 watts anyway. These LEDs have a little slot on one of the leads indicating the negative terminal or cathode. To drive the ring, I used an MT4608 step-up module. I removed the pot and inserted a 10K pot with switch in series, which will allow me to adjust the LED's brightness in between a small range. Everything was wired as shown in this schematic. The switch is used to cut the power to the module. Instead of having to handle a big roll of solder, I got this trick from a very good friend. Just roll a bit of solder inside an empty solder wick package. Besides being a lot more convenient to handle, this way I also don't contaminate the solder with my sweaty fingers. You can check out the YouTube channel of my friend. He just started posting, but he has a lot of interesting tips and I think you will like him. You can find the link in the description. I designed and 3D printed an enclosure to fit everything inside. Before soldering the LED ring to the output of the step-up module, I made sure I had the correct voltage by turning the 10K pot all the way to the max and adjusting the blue pot to the maximum desired voltage, which I decided to be around 21 volts for the 7 LEDs that I'm using. As you can tell, I am driving them very low, which in turn creates less heat and makes them more efficient. I tested the circuit with the LEDs, making sure it was working as planned. I then used hot glue on the solder joints to make sure nothing would come apart. To secure the board to the 3D printed enclosure, I just used double-sided sticky tape. I mounted everything inside the box. And here is the final result. As you can see, it works great with both models of microscopes, the ADSM-201 and the newest ADSM-302. All the links to everything I used are in the description, and by buying from them I get a small commission and it does not cost you anything. If you have any question, make sure to leave it in the comment section below, leave a like and subscribe, have fun and see you soon.